we're not going to have any weights in our hands. We're going to go through all the moves that we're going to do without weights. Then we'll go through them with the heavier weights, maybe the heaviest weights. And if we have time, we'll go through them one more time with lighter weights or no weights. The choice will be yours. Most of this class is standing. There's going to be upper and lower body work, so be prepared for squats and kneeling and so on and so forth. Now, if you have bad knees, don't bend as much. Be very mindful of what you do with your body. We're going to pose. So, come into chair. You sink your hips back and down. Make sure when you look down that you can see your toes. This is an inhale. Standing up is the exhale. Inhale to sit, exhale to stand. And you swing your arms up and over as you inhale, out and down as you exhale. Take this at your own pace, with your own breath's pace. Two more. Last one. All right. You're going to take your feet a little bit wide. We're going to continue with the chair, except we're going to be wide-legged. You'll sink your hips down, swing your arms up. As you stand up, you'll just take your arms back. So inhale. Exhale. Continue to do this at your own breath's pace, at your own range of motion. Last one. Take a moment. Keep your feet out. This is our little break. We're going to go back to wide legs. And what's going to happen when we have our weights, they'll be right here at our shoulders. We will punch to the opposite side, and you notice I turn this foot and come up on my toes. You'll come back and do the other side. Punch. And you have a little bend when you come in the middle. Doing this cross body gets the whole body into it. And again, when we go through this with the weights, you can always do it without. One more on this side, and that side, come to center. You're going to turn your feet out. You're going to come into a squat of sorts. This is where we would be with our weights. Exhale, straighten, and arms go up. Inhale, exhale. Really press into your big toe mound to keep you grounded and stable. Two more. Last one. And then your arms would come out to here. You turn your feet forward and you go from one side to the other. One more here, one more there. Come to center, arms would come down. We're going to go ahead and grab our weights. You choose how hard you want to work. The first thing we're doing is chair. And hopefully I remember what we're doing with our arms, so if we do something different, that's okay. This is the inhale, and this is the exhale. Now, if your arms get tired, and they can, you can take a break and just do the chair. Again, you can bring the arms back into it. Drop the arms, take a little break, step side to side, all right? We're doing the wide chair now. So, inhale and exhale, take them back. one. All right. Take a moment. Kick your legs out a little bit. Give yourself a little break. And we go into the wide squat. So we start here, I do believe. And when we bend, the arms go up. Inhale. Exhale. Four, three, two, last one. I know I'm feeling it. All right, we're getting ready to do the punch. Remember, we punch and we twist and we come up on the opposite ball on the foot. Take your time. Don't rush. This is a cross-body exercise, so we're working from our heads to our toes and everything in between. One more on this side, one more on that side. All right. I'm not sure I can remember what we were doing, but we're going to take it down a notch. And if I skip something, it's okay. We're still getting it in the end anyway, aren't we? All right. Time for that chair. Inhale. Exhale. A lot easier with the lighter weights if you've switched. Four, three, two, last one. Ooh, shake it out. You can even twist your wrist a little bit, kind of loosen it all up. All right, we're going to go into that wide chair, and this time the arms go back. So, inhale. Exhale. I know I'm getting tired. Four, three, two, one. All right, take a moment. Woo. This is a lot of work for someone who is a stroke survivor, but we're going to do it anyway. All right, we're going to go into the punching parts next, so... punch and just reach across. And don't think we're done just because we're going to move to the floor. We're going to keep our light weights when we go. One more. Last one. All right. We're going to come to the floor. If you need a cushion for your knees, go ahead and get it. But to start, we're just going to sit. And we're going to take a moment to let our body calm down just a second. Let the heart rate slow down a little bit. We're going to take 5 full breaths. It'll be a little break. That's 2. That's 3. That's 4. One more. All right. We're going to come on to our hands and knees. But the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take your left leg forward. And you're going to be kneeling on your right leg. And I'm probably telling you the wrong side, but it's close enough. We're going to take both of our arms up. This is the inhale. And this is the exhale. Inhale up, exhale down. 2 more. Last one. Go ahead and take your arms up. And you're going to bring them right by your shoulder. And if you're kneeling on your right knee, you're going to drop your right hand to the floor. And extend your left arm up. So basically you're twisting. And then you're just going to come back up. So what will happen, you'll drop the arm and raise the other. And then bring them back up to center. So the movement is this. And then you add leaning forward, finding the floor. And then coming back to center. I know it's tough. If you need a block, feel free to grab one, or maybe you don't even reach the floor all the way. But we'll do one more on this side. And then bring your hands to your waist. Bring that leg back. Bring the other leg forward. Take a moment to get your footing. Press that toe mound into the floor to keep your balance. Inhale. Exhale, drop them to the side. And if you feel your balance off, just try to regain it. 2 more. Last one. Take a break. Let your hands rest on top of that thigh. Take your arms out in front. This time, whatever foot you're kneeling on, that's the hand that drops down. So let's practice just separating the arms. drops, the other one goes up. All right, come back to center. As you drop that arm, reach for the floor, and then come back up. Ooh, that's a little bit hard on that shoulder. So I'm going to drop the weights, and that's quite all right. And I'm going to grab a block. Sometimes we just need to do what we got to do. And yes, I'm wobbly just like anybody else. This is a twist and a stretch. Two more. Last one. All right. Let's come down here and let's sit for a moment. If you don't need your block, put it up. Sit cross-legged and comfortable. We're going to let our legs rest. We're going to keep the weights in our hands. Take a couple of breaths here. Bring your weights in front of your chest. Elbows are pointed out. And you'll open and come together. Inhale, exhale. Inhale to open, exhale to close. Two more. Last one going out. Bring your hands to face forward. Your palms are facing forward. Your elbows are down by your side. And just go up. Inhale up. Exhale down. Two more. Last one. Set your weights aside. You are done with them. Take your feet out in front. Lean back on your hands if you can. I'm leaning on the window. Nope. I could though. It feels really good just to lean back. All right. Bend one knee followed by the other. And just windshield wiper side to side. Lift your chest up. Open up that chest and the shoulder area in the front. All right. Take both feet out in front and kick them out. And you can pat them down. This is good for your circulation. And you can rub them back and forth. Just slide back and forth. And you don't have to reach your toes or your ankles, but you're just rocking back and forth over your thighs. And you're not even trying to reach. You're just letting your hands slide up and down from your knees to your shins. Cooling down. Begin to slow down. All right. Go ahead and bring your feet back in. Sit up nice and tall. We're going to do a couple of seated cat-cows. So you inhale, lift your chest. Take your elbows and your shoulder blades back towards each other. As if your elbows were going behind your back, your hands stay glued to your knees. Exhale, you round your back, try to create a C. Inhale, and here I am exhaling, but that's okay. Inhale to open and stretch out. Exhale to round. In all honesty, just as long as you're breathing in at one point and breathing out at the other, that's all that yoga is placing your breath with a movement. All right, sit up nice and tall. Drop your chin towards your chest. You're going to interlace your fingers and place them at the back of your head. You're not pushing down. You're just letting your hands add weight to the back of your head. Release your hands, bring your head up to center, gently turn your gaze over your left shoulder, your eyes are closed. If you'd like, you can take your left hand and place it on the back of your head again and tilt your head down into your left shoulder. Release your hand before bringing your head back upright and bringing it to center and taking it over to the right. Again, you may take your right hand behind your head and gently tuck your chin towards your right shoulder. Slowly release your hand first. Bring your gaze to neutral and slowly turn your head forward. Bring your hands together at your heart. We'll take two more sighing breaths. The light in me honors the light in each of you. I hope that you all have a wonderful evening and that you enjoyed tonight's class. And I will see you tomorrow on Thanksgiving Day at some point for more yoga. Until then, happy Thanksgiving and peace out.